Spirit move over me. Spirit move over me. Holy Spirit, move me now.
Shall we continue to watch as our flesh shuts the mouth of our spirits and leads our souls to hell? Because we are his sons, he sent the spirit of his son into our hearts, the spirit that cries out, Abba, Father. How long will we allow our ears to be filled with lies, lies with the guise of sensible questions produced by human nature? Our nature itself has been compromised, for from the fall of Adam and Eve, we are gripped with the jinn, the spirit, if you may, to know what is good and what is evil, to think of it. It was in us wanting to know that we fell in the first place. Shut the voice of the questioning spirit. All it is after is to confuse us. That same spirit that would want you to find out if there is a God and life after death and a heaven and a hell and will make you suicidal. That spirit is from nowhere but hell. We inherited sin. We inherited death. That should have been our end. But mercy said, no. Jesus came life. He died our death to shut the voices out. So call on him when weighed with the weight of the world. He wants us to stand still and know just one thing, that he is your God. So are you waiting for a reason to call on him? To surrender your life to him? Do you want to see the gates of hell before you call on the name of Jesus? But whoever is united with the Lord is one with him in spirit. 1 Corinthians 6:17. Which means the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the God of the universe, will be merged with your spirit. A person opportune to be such a carrier of the presence of the Most High will literally be walking in the supernatural. How can his life not make perfect sense? It's hard to believe, but it is true. You are opportune. Congratulations. Just call on him. Accept him. Give your life to him. And let him be your God.
Please be sure to subscribe by clicking on the subscription button right